All things Marvel, huh? Well, to be honest, there really isn't all that much to it. As straightforward as it is, though, I do imagine folk may still not know where to begin looking or how to make farming the stuff easier, so that is our goal today, to make obtaining Marvel easier while learning what to do with it. And to start, we must stumble upon some chest biomes. And yes, these locations you might have seen before are technically their own biomes, even given their much smaller size. But they come in numerous variations, but just about always have a plethora of structures to play with, like different marble statues and pillars. Maybe even grand marble sculptures, including one of the puppet master himself. And yes, you can even run into some rare marble trees along the way too. A select few of these sculptures do drop figure sketches when mined, so do make note, base decorators. There's a heck of a lot of sketches to get to, so keep an eye out for some new statues to destroy. Remember, these locations are biomes, so you can distinguish them always using the information already provided, or just looking for carpeted and checkered flooring, as these turfs are a given in these places. Plus, it's like you're going to be running into some clockworks around these parts too, so be prepared for a bit of a scuffle now and then. Now that you've smashed and grabbed some marble for yourself, I need you to go ahead and think ahead to mass production of the stuff. And to do so, we are gonna need some marble beans. They only use but one marble to make a bean, so we're gonna use what we got to create our very own marble forests. These beans can be planted just like normal pine cones, and they will soon be growing into what are known as marble shrubs. There are three sizes of them, starting with stage one here. It will take about 2 to 5 minutes for the growth process to really begin and for it to reach this stage, and then there is a 100% chance for a single marble piece to drop when these are mined. But if you use one marble to make them and then you get one marble when mining them, there's no point to mine these at stage one. Wait 5 to 6 days and the shrub will enter stage two. And then it has a 75% chance to drop but a single marble versus a 25% chance to drop a marble piece as well as another marble bean, thus making marble and your marble tree farms renewable. But wait yet another 5 to 6 days to reach stage three, a stage that sees a 50% chance to walk away with two marble pieces alone or a 50% chance to get a single marble with a bean. Either way, you're getting the resource or getting what you need to keep on getting the resource, so it's a win-win. If you are in the marble, I implore you, create your own marble farms. Plus, not all of them look so rounded, so you can have some little variety in decorations too if you don't plan on mining them. What else can we do with the hard stuff? Well, there's checkerboard flooring, I guess, but it's more of a decorative turf, but still worth mentioning anyway. It's the same turf you'll be seeing in these chest biomes we've discussed, and replacing just normal turf with it will prevent lure plant spawns. It will also prevent you from planting any resources yourself, unless of course you plant the resources, then place the turf below it all afterwards. And crows will be the only birds that will land on the turf itself, so make note there if you want some jet feathers. We got the marble suit, an armor that will set us back 12 total marble, but trust me, it's coming with perks. It has 735 durability and it will absorb 95% of physical damage done to the player, making it a fantastic choice for those who prefer tanking. The downside is that the armor will drop your speed by 30%, but just look at this here. Klops is barely dealing 4 damage to me right now. I mean, come on. You're gonna be wearing this armor for the tanking. It's not like you're gonna be wearing it just to run around, so the speed boost really doesn't mean anything. But here's something I reckon folk don't really know much about. The stagehand. It's likely the thing that has given you a fright and sudden heart attacks as it moves about at night looking for a light source. But we aren't here for just some sentient table. We are here for what it holds, the blueprint for end tables. You'll need to hammer the stagehand a whopping 86 times. Yes, 86 times in order for the blueprint to drop. So, have fun. And oh yeah, don't wait too long between hammer strikes as the counter can and will reset back to 86. The blueprint read, you can now create your very own decorative tables with 2 marble, 2 boards, and 2 carpeted flooring. One can place flowers in the pots to gain 5 sanity each time, and get some lovely little variations and some decorations around your base. Or place light bulbs and glowberries within them for lights around the base. Whatever is placed will only last 2.5 days, however, but you will be able to replace them now and then. But as I have shown before, end tables are far more than purely decorative. They can be used to effectively block mobs and create efficient farms, as even big bads won't be able to pass through end tables. We've already found and mined a crap ton of marble sculptures, I'm sure, but what about all the ones that we can make ourselves? Whatever the case, we're gonna need a potter's wheel to even begin, so make sure to get you one. Then, placing cut stone, even the new moon shards from the lunar biome, and yes, marble on top of one unlocks the recipes for numerous decorative statues for your pleasure. But again, some of these, you're gonna need the sketches from the mine sculptures. Don't do drugs, kids. Instead, blow bubbles. Create a giant statue to commemorate the bubble-blowing tobacco pipe that is the bubble pipe carving. It's never too early to have a lovely Thanksgiving feast, so why not start on the centerpiece and create the Hornucopia already, yeah? If you've mined Maxwell's statue, you likely got a kingly figure sketch for a kingly figure. Cause we all know, behind every queen is a dapper king. But always remember that the queen is the most powerful piece on the board. I think the game is trying to tell us something here, but honestly, now all I want to do is just play chess. We also got the pawn figure, but it's a frickin' pawn figure, so there's not much else to say there. Moving on. We've showcased these in the past, but always remember that you can show off your big bad murdering skills with 4 figures corresponding to the seasonal bosses, Deerclops, Moose Goose, and Bearger, and even one for Dragonfly herself. And if you've already conquered the Shadow Pieces boss fight, you also have 3 figures available that correspond to Clockworks. The Rook figure, the Knight figure, and the Bishop figure. These can be moved around to new player-built arenas for future Shadow Piece boss fights. But I wish to discuss another aspect of marble that leads to all of these. Suspicious marble. There are pieces of them doubted about the constant, and 3 of them must be brought to a specific marble sculpture biome to construct clockwork-related structures. And if we wait for a new moon, that is when us and the Shadow Pieces are gonna have a word with each other. Or we can wait till a full moon for the corresponding clockwork to spawn for some extra gears. Marble, 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 baby. It's actually bloody important if you think about it. And honestly, that's about it, folks. Yes, I do know there are new statues that came with the Return of Them update. And yes, I know you can get marble via respawning at touchstones. And triple yes, I know marble can drop from earthquakes. But there's no need to drag on the conversation any longer. Marble may not be the most important resource out there, but knowing that it is easily renewable creates a hefty armor for emergencies, and that it can lead to some extra gears outside of the ruins, that is worth it enough in my opinion. Thanks for watching, everyone. Well wishes to all. I hope you learned something new out there, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.